Joining us now to break down the Republican agenda and how it plays into the 2020 race is Representative Debbie Lesko, the congresswoman proudly serving the 8th District of Arizona. So, Congresswoman, I saw that you were yesterday alongside the president in your home state of Arizona in the city of Yuma. What was that experience like?
It was awesome. It was absolutely awesome. It is so energizing to see President Trump. And, you know, his message resonates. I mean, when you see hundreds of people waiting for hours in like 118 degree temperature in Yuma, Arizona, you know that Arizonans support President Trump. I mean, there was just enthusiasm. I was excited. It was great to greet him again when he came off of Air Force One. It was hot as heck, but we didn't care. We love him.
And we saw people in the crowd, too. I mean, they were sweating bullets, but they were nonetheless sitting right there with face masks, may I add, so that 118 that you're talking about may seem a little bit hotter. I know people in your home state like to say it's a dry heat, but 118 is 118 no matter what. But the reason why he was down there as well, one of the big pieces was to talk about the idea of illegal immigration. He wanted to talk about, for example, border security and what they're doing down there in the home state of Arizona. But it's a conversation that, as of recently, given the coronavirus and the protests and police reforms, it hasn't been at the forefront as much. So is immigration still one of the top topics, I should say, for Republicans?
Oh, most definitely, especially in Arizona. Illegal immigration has been a big problem in Arizona for many, many years. And when we've done polling for years and years, it's usually at the top. Now, probably defunding the police like these radical Democrats want to do and have been doing is probably at the top, but illegal immigration is really up there. And President Trump has done a great job. I mean, I just went to the border again yesterday after this and saw the new fence. They're already at 275 miles of new fence being built. They're going to be doing, what, 300 by the end of maybe this week or next week of miles. And, you know, it's just evident to me. You have law enforcement and the National Border Patrol Council endorsing President Trump, not Biden. I mean, so if one of the questions, the key questions, I think, is who do you trust to keep us safe? Americans, law enforcement, Border Patrol, they trust President Trump, and so do I.
Yeah, and I think it's worth noting, too, that the police associations across the country are largely endorsing President Trump as well. Really, if it comes down to law enforcement in any regard, it seems like they have taken a side in this election. And in some cases, it's very strange. I know that the National Police Union, for example, in the past has endorsed President Obama, and this time they're deciding not to endorse Joe Biden, but instead President Trump. We saw the same thing with the New York City Police Benevolent Association, also endorsing President Trump. So we're starting to see a pattern here a little bit when it comes to law enforcement. But there's also this kind of topic that overlaps all of this, and it's the idea of China's involvement in the United States. We could talk about the coronavirus pandemic, and a lot of the blame goes back to China. We could talk about the trade practices and economic practices that China is doing right now and how President Trump has taken them on. Is it really important for the next president, in this case, I must know that you're endorsing President Trump, to take on China, no matter who it is?
Oh, most definitely. And President Trump has been ahead of everybody else on this. I mean, remember in the 2016 election, he was saying, we need to change our policies in China. And before that, even Republicans were like, free trade, free trade. But it wasn't free trade with China. They were manipulating it and stealing our intellectual property. I mean, the deals that they would make with American companies, they basically had China taking their research and development. Trump saw this and he knew American workers first. America first, American workers first. And I'm so glad that he has taken this on. I think he's the only president that has really, really taken this on. And you've seen it in this whole coronavirus crisis where most of the medicine is made in China. The supply chains are in China. We cannot be reliant on China for all this stuff. It threatens our national security. We need to manufacture this stuff here. President Trump knows that. He's a clear choice. Biden supported all China, gave him, you know, favored trade and everything else. We lost so many jobs to China. Trump brought them back.
No, you're exactly right. And I think it's worth pointing out that one of the reasons that we're having this conversation so far after China's trade practices have been evident is because the people who were really affected by it were the people in middle America, the people, for example, in Michigan, Wisconsin, the farmers, the steel workers, things of that nature. The politicians in D.C. weren't dealing with unfair trade practices because they don't necessarily get affected by that as much. But I think that you're exactly right to say that free trade is a great thing. But that was not free trade. There's a reason why Democrats and Republicans can come together on the idea of putting on different trade imbalances on China because of what they've done over the past couple of years. And I think it's well past time to take action against China. And the coronavirus pandemic only highlighted those concerns. I think you're right on to say that. But Representative Lesko, I appreciate you coming on tonight and breaking down the Republican agenda moving forward. Thank you.